A blessed afternoon, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. We are now on the third day of our novena to Our Lady of Mount Carmel. This year, our theme, Beneath the Cross of Jesus Stood Mary, His Mother. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Leo Paulige of the Order of the Augustinian Recollects.
Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to be worthy to partake in this holy sacrifice, let us first call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for mercy and pardon. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Should be named in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son. Through her prayers, as we honor her today, bring us to everlasting joy in her company. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, when Israel was a child, I loved him. Out of Egypt, I called my son. The more I called them, the farther they went from me, sacrificing to the Baals and burning incense to idols. Yet it was I who taught Ephraim to walk, who took them in my arms. I drew them with human cords, with bands of love. I fostered them like one who raises an infant to his cheeks. Yet, though I stooped to feed my child, they did not know that I was their healer. My heart is overwhelmed. My pity is teared. I will not give vent to my blazing anger. I will not destroy Ephraim again. For I am God and not man, the Holy One present among you. I will not let the flames consume you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his apostles, "As you go, make this proclamation: the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, drive out demons. Without cost you have received, without cost you are to give. Do not take gold or silver or copper for your belts, no sack for the journey, or a second tunic, nor sandals, or walking stick. The laborer deserves his keep. Whenever town or village you enter, look for a worthy person in it, and stay there until you leave. As you enter a house, wish it peace. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. If not, let your peace return to you. Whoever will not receive you or listen to your words, go outside that house or town and shake the dust from your feet. Amen, I say to you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mayong hapon sa tanan. So as I said, we are now on the third day of our novena to Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Relating our readings and especially the Gospel with our situation now, we are given a hope. Because humanly speaking, after sometimes our patience, our tolerance are getting thinner and thinner, to the end that sometimes we want to rebel against God, saying, God has forgotten us. And even sometimes others would go against maybe the commandment just to feed his family, whatever needs. But the Gospel and the mission given by Jesus to the apostles, this is a particular command of Jesus to the apostles. Because there was one time also he gave this mission to the disciples, to the 72. But now, it is only for the apostles. Looking into the description of the Gospel, the apostles have to go without nothing with them, only the Word of God. But this Word of God is full of power in response to the need of the people. Before the word could be accepted, that is also natural to us. The physical needs or the earthly needs are necessary. That is why the power was given to them to cure the sick. And we know the greatest challenge in our life is when your loved ones is affected with a kind of sickness that nobody knows the cure. But if only we remain faithful and trusting to God, as the first reading described, God did not leave behind or alone his people in Egypt. He took it like a child So God was like a mother, caring for a newly born child who is so helpless, who cries, knowing nothing. And he guided his people until they were able to reach the promised land, where they were rewarded with abundance along the way for 40 years. Their faith was being purified by all kinds of trials. So trial is not only once. We even say, as long as we breathe, trials is there. Only the dead are not tried anymore. So from the beginning, we have to accustom ourselves with trials. As we see, the first, usually 99% act of a newly born child is to cry. Why? Because he is now, or she is now, out of the comfort of the womb, where he or she was well protected. Not even, because now there are threats to the child in the womb. But more or less, when we come into this world, we have nothing. We are nothing. It is in God that parents should entrust their children. That is why the church advises us to have the child as early as possible receive the sacrament of baptism, so that the weak human constitution will be strengthened by the grace of God. And the life, the eternal life that God has promised, will be with a child. He will not only live with the life he received through his or her parents, but now the grace of God to assure that person of his salvation. He may die at young age, but assured to inherit the kingdom of the Father. And that is how Christ, how the scripture describes in the first reading, how the prophet described the love of God to his people. And God is not wanting of this help. That even Jesus, before his own death, he tried, maybe he was already hardened to breath. And the last moment, one of his last words was to entrust us to her mother, as we have the theme at the foot of the cross. Mary is there, and Jesus entrusts us in the person of John, so that his absence will not be lacking to his brothers and sisters, because they have that mother whom God himself has selected. It was not Jesus who selected his mother. It was God the Father. Because from the beginning, before even Jesus was conceived through the Holy Spirit, Mary was already there, conceived without sin, in preparation for the coming of the Savior. And that is why Mary will never stop her mission of helping us. It is not only years before that Mary has let her love felt by us. She will continue in every moment of our needs, as long as we also remain faithful to the Father. Because she cannot do anything if we do not recognize God as our Father. She is only a helper, a handmaid, doing the work entrusted by the Father, like maybe our handmaids. They are waiting to be instructed, to be sent. Like the apostles, they were sent by Jesus with a clear instruction. Do not disturb yourselves with material things. Do not carry gold, silver, copper, not even a second tunic, not even a sandal, without provision. Because if people receive the word of God, they will surely receive you and provide you with your needs. And he advised them, you have received without cost, and you have to give without cost. Give not only their time, but including their lives. As we have seen the apostles, they offer their lives to give witness to the word, for that is the highest way of showing their faith. And that is what our Blessed Mother also wants of us. And we are now, maybe this time is a kind of purification of our faith. Because sometimes, or maybe before, we have already forgotten God. We think, or we thought, that because of our material abundance, we don't need God. It's time, maybe, to regroup our family, to pray together, to share together what God has given us, our time. Maybe before, we have no time to be with one another. But now, this is a kind of, maybe, a blessing in disguise. Not maybe easy for us to understand, but if only we accept the word, then that word that has become flesh will be part of our lives. We receive that flesh that will strengthen us, help us grow in our relationship with God. And this is what we need. Let us continue asking the help of the Blessed Mother, like the star in the ocean. The travelers, especially before, without any compass or maybe without any instruments, they were only guided by the stars, especially at night, and they reached their destination. And that is one maybe picture of our Mother leading us always to God, because she has no other mission in this world. Not even maybe while she is now with the Father, the more she'll be there to watch over us, to direct us, as long as we follow, we listen. Remembering that first miracle of Jesus at the wedding feast at Cana, what did Mary say to the waiters? Do whatever he tells you. She does not teach us other things, but what his son has taught us. Because she herself was the first disciple when Jesus said to her with Joseph at the finding at the temple, don't you know that I must be at my Father's house? Maybe it's a kind of insult, a harsh word to Mary. But the evangelist said, Mary guarded all the words in her heart, trying to understand, accepting. Even Jesus was still a child, but his wisdom is from the Father. And that is a challenge to us.
We shall not look outside, maybe false prophets there, but only return to God with Mary, and all of these trials will end with us victorious and coming into the will of the Father.
Please all rise.
Let us pray to our Heavenly Father, bringing to Him our desperate plea for mercy as we go through the unprecedented time of adversity, as we beg Our Lady of Mount Carmel to lovingly intercede for us. For every petition we say, Lord, grant us your mercy.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For the Church, our Holy Father Pope Francis, all bishops and clergy, and all consecrated men and women, that they may authentically mirror God's love and compassion to all peoples, living their lives in solidarity with the poor and the suffering. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For the leaders of all nations, especially of our own country, as they carry the burden of this global health and economic crisis, may sincere and selfless concern for the welfare of the people be the root and motivation of all their undertakings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For all frontliners who risk their lives to take care of the sick and render basic services to the people, may they be protected from the contagion of COVID and be given the physical and spiritual stamina to withstand the demands of their noble tasks. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For all of us who feel the pinch of this pandemic and economic crisis, may this global and communal journey in darkness and uncertainty occasion a spiritual rebirth, deeper prayerfulness, greater compassion and mindfulness of others, humble acknowledgement of our dependence on God, and confident trust in His unfailing help. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For the whole order of Carmel, friars, nuns, and secular members, that they may generously share in the steadfast and invincible faith of our Blessed Mother, with the flame of love burning ever brightly in their hearts as they embrace the whole humanity in their prayers and sacrifices. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For those in distress and those who experience hopelessness, the sick, particularly all COVID patients, those in quarantine and isolation, the stranded, the jobless, those who grieve and mourn for the loss of a loved one, may God's healing and consoling presence and His providential care be ever with them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
For all the faithful departed, especially those who perished because of the pandemic, welcome them, Father, to your kingdom, and may our Blessed Mother be the refuge and strength of their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
We pray in silence for all other personal intentions we carry in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, grant us your mercy.
Almighty and loving Father, your infinite mercy goes beyond our fondest hope and expectation. Look with pity on the sufferings of your people and listen to all their yearnings. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please all rise.
Pray, brethren, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, we reverently offer you these gifts in memory of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. In your service, may our love become like hers, and in so unite us more closely with the work of redemption. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Father, powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. As we honor the Blessed Virgin Mary, she shares with Christ his work of salvation, and with his church she brings forth sons and daughters, whom she calls to walk the path of perfect love. She claims us also as her beloved children, clothed in the habit of her order, shield us all along out our way of holiness, and in her likeness set us before the world, so that our hearts like hers may ever contemplate your word, love our brethren, and draw them to her Son. In our joy we sing in your glory with all the choirs of angels.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Patricio our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, and may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Thank you.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Thank you.
Please all rise.
Let us pray. Lord, you have strengthened us with food from heaven. May the remembrance of Our Lady of Mount Carmel always bring us happiness and peace in the knowledge of her protection, and help us to become what you want us to be. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer to our Blessed Mother, Most Holy Virgin. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God, in the present tragic situation, when the whole world is praying
to suffering,
pray to the suffering with anxiety. Turn your merciful eyes toward us amidst the coronavirus pandemic. Comfort those who are distraught and mourn their loved ones who have died. Be close to those whose loved ones are infected, yet cannot be close to them. Fill with hope those who are troubled by uncertainty and have lost their jobs in a failing economy. Mother of God and our Mother, pray for us to God, the Father of mercies, that this great suffering may end and that hope and peace may dawn anew. Plead with your Divine Son so that the sick and their families be comforted. Protect the doctors, nurses, and health workers who are on the front line of this emergency and risk their lives to save others. Be close to those who assist the sick night and day, and to the priests who continue their pastoral ministry to serve the sick and everyone. Blessed Virgin, illuminate the minds of those engaged in scientific research to find effective cure to overcome this virus. Support national leaders that with wisdom, solicitude, and generosity, they may address the basic needs of their suffering people and devise social and economic solution to help them survive. Mary, Most Holy, steer our consciences to work for peace, that the enormous funds invested in developing arms may be spent in promoting research to prevent similar future tragedies. Beloved Mother, help us realize that we are all members of one great family, that in a spirit of fraternity and solidarity, we can alleviate situations of poverty and need. Make us strong in faith, persevering in service, and constant in prayer. Mary, consolation of the afflicted, embrace all your children in distress, and pray that God will stretch out his all-powerful hand and free us from the terrible pandemic, that life can serenely resume its normal course. To you who shine on our journey as a sign of salvation and hope, do we entrust ourselves, O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary. All this we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
We shall now sing the hymn, Flower of Carmel. seated for a while. We have reached the third day of our novena, and we thank you for your faithful attendance and participation, in spite of all the health protocols we have to go through. God reads our hearts, and He will bless and protect His people. We are grateful to Father Leo Paulige, OAR, who celebrated the Novena Mass today, to our Eucharistic ministers, the altar servers, reader, and the ADSUM, DYAF, and Bacolod Cable Channel 6, who facilitate the live streaming, and the Carmel Sunday Choir, who accompanies our liturgy with a beautiful singing. We give them all a round of applause. May we begin the grace to continue to come together for the rest of the Novena days. Carmel prays faithfully for you and your family, your good health and protection. A blessed day, and may God bless us all. After the final blessing, we shall have the blessing of the scapulars. For the distribution, we shall follow the forming of lines, one at the center and one at each side of the altar, following the lines during the communion. Thank you. Please all rise.
Blessing of the scapular. Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
O Lord, hear my prayer.
And let my cry come to you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord Jesus Christ, Savior of mankind, by your right hand, sanctify these scapulars, which your servant will devoutly wear, for the love of you and of your mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel. By her intercession, may they be protected from the wickedness of the enemy, and persevere in your grace until death, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.